In this video, I'm going to be adding some text, and then I'm going to be using the scale transformation and the distort transformation tools. So I could just come over here and use the text tool and just start typing here. And then change my font, my size and everything. But for this tutorial, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go to Google Chrome. So let me just delete this. So I just right clicked and selected delete. So I'm going to go to Google Chrome, and there's this saying here, this quote that I like, and I'd rather use this than typing it all out. So we're basically just going to be using this as a template. I'm not going to steal this image. Well, I am temporarily, but just to use it as a template. So I just came up here and I typed in quotes about being crazy because I think it's a funny image and I think this quote suits the image. And then I zoomed in and I'm just going to take a screenshot. So Shift Command 4 on a Mac. I'm not sure how you do screenshots on Windows. And then I'm going to go back to PhotoDirector and I'm going to bring in that image that we just saved as a screenshot. So I went ahead and I renamed my screenshot so that it would be easier to find it. So come up here to add a new layer and then add a photo layer and then select from folder. And there is my screenshot and I renamed it. People may think I'm crazy. So whatever, wherever and where, whatever you renamed your screenshot, just double click it. And now we want to remove the black background. So come over here to the select area tool. And we're going to select the magic wand tool, so click that, and then change your tolerance level. You may have to experiment with it. And then click on the black and make sure that contiguous is not checked. And the reason we don't want it checked, let me just show you. If I check it and I select the black, it doesn't select the black inside of the A and the R. So we have to uncheck contiguous, and let's do it again. And this time it selected everything. So then just come over here and delete the selection. And then clear your selection. So the other thing I'm going to do is remove the white and the blue. So with your magic wand tool selected, click on the white and then click on the blue and then delete the selection and let's turn off the background layer. And now we're going to fill it in with solid black. So come over here to the fill tool. And it defaulted to black, so I'm just going to keep it on that. And then I'm just going to click in the letters. And it fills it in. And then Command D clears your selection, or if you select your Select Area tool, come over here and clear the selection that way. So either Command D on a Mac or the Clear Selection tool. And we can turn our background on now. And we can resize this text. So go up here to the pick and move tool and just click and drag and move it to wherever you want it to be. And then now I'm going to distort the text. So click on distort transformation. And then I'm going to click on the left, top left corner and then the bottom left corner. And then right here in the middle on the right side, just gonna stretch it out a bit like that. And then click the checkbox to accept it. So now I'm gonna show you how I would do it by using the text tool. So click on the text tool and select your font. So I'm going to go with this new Penimum MT, and I think 200 will be too big, so I'm going to highlight 200 and I'm going to type in 150 and then just click and start typing. And then you may need to resize your text box, so just click and drag it. Whoops, I spelt that wrong. Should be a K. So that's one line, and then I'm going to add the second line. So go back down to your main image and just click where you want to start typing. And then just grab your text box and click and drag your text box. And then move it to where you want it to be. Now I want to resize this one. So I'm just going to double click. And I'm going to change the size to 250. So just highlight that. Double click it to highlight it. And then just change it to the size you want it to be. And we can also use the pick and move tool to change it if we want afterwards. I'm going to leave it at this for now. So click out of there. And then I'm going to add the last line. So come back down to your main image. And click the text tool again. And then just start typing. But my size went to 500 for some reason. So I have to put it back to 150. The same size as the first line, and then just click and start typing. Click OK, then resize it. So now we can start playing with the sizing. So go up to the first line and double click. And I'm going to come over here and choose set text character spacing. So just click there and you can see how the spacing changes. You may have to change the size of your text box. So let's try that at 60 and resize our text box. There we go. And then do the same thing for the last line. So double click. And then move the I'm crazy text over. So click the pick and move tool. And then just center that. And then I'm gonna make it bigger. So I'm gonna click on the corner. And I'm going to change the spacing also. So I'm going to go back to the text tool and double click and change my spacing. Let's see how that looks. Go back to the pick and move tool and then just move that over. So I'm going to accept that, and now I have to merge all three of those lines. So with the top one selected, hold down the shift key and then click the other two, and then right click and then merge selected. And now we can start distorting and transforming the text. So click on Distort Transformation, and then we just do the same thing we did earlier. And then click the checkbox.